Greetings of the day to everybody. Hope you all are safe and healthy in your houses. This is Mansi Rajput and Rajesh Sharma, pursuing B Pharmacy from KR Mangalam University, Gurugram, Haryana. Today we are presenting a short introduction about COVID-19. As our journal was published in International Journal of Science and Research in Volume 9, Issue 3 in March 2020. And the topic is Coronavirus, a Catastrophe and Bout. Here, we are going to discuss about everything related to coronavirus, whether it is history, whether it is transmission, whether it is about its diagnosis, or it is about its treatment. We are going to discuss about it all. Coronaviruses are pathogens which are believed to be originated from bats. When certain agglomeration of pneumonia cases come forward at the end of 2019 in Hubei province of Wuhan, China, which are present in humans and animals. And due to its easy spread and a being communicable disease, WHO declared it as a pandemic on 11th March. It is attributed by club-like spikes projecting from its surface and having a unique replication strategy. It proliferated rapidly throughout China and to the other countries due to its zoonotic origin. WHO assigned the disease with the name COVID-19 in February 2020. The disease escalated from China to 26 other countries as of Feb 18, 2020. However, replication of the phylogenetic material takes place on a zoonotic origin. That is why person-to-person transmission is responsible for the electricity spread of the virus. Various studies offer ancillary enlightenment into person-to-person transmission. In India, the beginning of the coronavirus pandemic started on the January 30th, 2020. That too in a student who had returned from Wuhan University to Kerala. This was the first case in India from 2019-2020. The Ministry of Health and Family Welfare has established a whole of 5 to 9K cases and 16K deaths in the country as of 28 June 2020. Maharashtra, Delhi and Tamil Nadu have the highest number of cases of coronavirus patients and cases in the India. So now we are going to discuss about the history. Do it have any other species also? How it originated? This will be explained by Rajesh Sharma to you.
So let's talk about the history. First of all, I want to tell about the MERS. What is MERS? MERS is a Middle East Respiratory Syndrome. MERS emerged in 2012, responsible for causing acute respiratory illness. First case was reported in Saudi Arabia. MERS spread from bats to other animals before radiating to humans. Now, we will start about the coronavirus. SARS-CoV-2 coronavirus, seemingly close to SARS coronavirus, emerged in Wuhan, China, in late 2019, causing illness named as COVID-19. And was characterized primarily by fever and respiratory symptoms. Viruses are similarly pandemic. World tour by the tourists as a result of WHO promulgated the outbreak to the pandemic. As you can see the schematic diagram of the earth, how the coronavirus disease spread from China to other countries. So let's talk about its life cycle, how it's replicate in human body. So my colleague Mansi will introduce about this.
Okay, now we are here discussing about its life cycle. The group 2 murine model of coronavirus and mouse hepatitis virus are the finest model for studying the coronavirus, and the most of the knowledge is determined by studying its life cycle in animals and in culture using the virus. Here, center of attention will be MHV juxtapositioning SARS-CoV and other coronaviruses. So, host proteins and coronaviruses life cycles. Here it is. The virus enters the host cell by attaching to its receptors present on the surface of the host cell body and coating of the ribonucleocapsid is followed by the entry, which in turn exposes the positive sense genomic RNA and the host ribosomes carry out translation yielding the viral replication complex. The host proteins such as HNRN and PA1 sucker in the genome replication and viral transcription, and the viral replication complex continues to grow. This process yields a set of positive subgenomic mRNAs along with the full-length virus genome. After translation, the subgenomic sites mRNAs are converted to viral structures such as S, E, M, and N, and accessory proteins with the help of host ribosomes. The positive sense genomic RNA is packed into a ripe nucleocapsid by the N protein, and beta acting helps in congregating into the virus particles. This step is followed by the maturation as they pass through the Golgi apparatus. The virus leaves the host cell by exocytosis after utilizing its cell machinery for replication. Its diagnosis will be covered by Rajesh Sharma.
So let's talk about the diagnosis, how the coronavirus is detected. So we have four types of diagnosis techniques. First of all, talk about the nucleic acid amplification test, NAT, for COVID-19 virus. Detection of unique sequence of virus RNA is done by NAT, such as real-time inverse transcription polymerase chain reaction. And confirmation of nucleic acid sequence is done when necessary for routine confirmation. N, E, S, and R, RDP viral genes are aimed at so far. So let's talk about the serology test. The people who has been wide open to the virus can easily be detected using this test. During infection, these bodies are produced as a body immune responsible to attack the virus, bacteria, and other microbes during infection. The person once infected will develop these antibodies against the virus, and hence the patient may have encountered the virus previously. So let's talk about the viral sequencing. Furthermore, to the confirmation of the presence of the virus, the percentage from the regular sequencing of specimens from clinical cases is useful in monitoring viral genome mutations. These mutations can have a counter effect on performance, including diagnostic tests. The deposition of genetic sequence is available, including GSID, protecting the rights of submitting parties. Now, move to the next technique, that is viral culture. It is a typical culture of the virus, the culture of coronavirus. This method does not involve the fall under routine diagnostic procedure. It requires a culture protein, culture medium to grow a coronavirus. So let's talk about the transmission, how COVID virus transmits from one person to other. Due to zoonotic origin, transmission becomes more rapid, hence it can be transmitted through droplets that an infected person may drop during sneezing, coughing, wheezing. These small aerosolized droplets can travel a large distance through air and can live in up air up to 24 hours. Direct contact is to avoid it as much as possible. The disease is easily communicable, and hence utmost precautions should be taken. So we talk about the lifespan of the coronavirus on different materials like plastic. It say up to 2 to 3 days. On stainless steel, it lasts up to 2 to 3 days. On cardboard, up to 1 day, and copper, up to 4 hours. As you can see, the transmission is in human. Now we talk about the symptoms. What are the symptoms the patients have? The symptoms are the combination of the symptoms can be appear in 2 to 14 days of exposure. The symptoms are fever, cough, shortness and breath, joint pain, renal failure, nursing, running zone, sore throat, can lead to pneumonia or dyspnea, headache. These symptoms appear from mild to severe illness, and the death for confirmed coronavirus disease, COVID-19 cases. So here are the some few points about the symptoms, as you see, you can see over the slides. So let's talk about the prevention, how we can prevent from the coronavirus transmission. So there are few points to overtaken to stop the transmission of coronavirus and to prevent yourself from COVID-19 disease. You can use warm water and soap to wash your hands. Hand sanitizer should be used having isopropyl alcohol up to 70%. Use of face mask is recommended during traveling, working, talking, and any other social gathering. Public gathering and overcrowded places like hospitals, schools, colleges, gyms, and clubs should be ignored. Avoid touching your face whenever you are in day-to-day life. Avoid traveling if you feel sick. Maintain a distance at least of 3 feet or 1 meter from anyone who is suffering from sneeze and cough. Always cover your mouth while sneezing or coughing. Immediately away use tissues. Clean using disinfectant on frequently use items like phones, computer, utensils. As we can say, prevention is better than cure. Now, the treatment and the latest R&D updates will be talked about my colleague Mansi. So here are you.
As we talk about the treatment of COVID-19, many researches are going on and few potent drugs like remdesivir, a drug, is used to cure COVID-19 in USA and approved by US FDA. Remdesivir triphosphate acts as an analog of adenosine triphosphate, ATP, and results in delayed chain termination during replication of the viral RNA. However, BCG vaccines are also useful to treat COVID-19. BCG is 30 to 50% helping in the reduction in mortality due to reduction in the respiratory tract infection and neonatal sepsis. However, BCG is also protecting us against viral infection. But it is not commonly preferred as it is used to treat acute tuberculosis in children and geriatric patients. If whole of the supply of BCG vaccine shifts towards the coronavirus patients, there will be a deficiency of BCG vaccines for the patients who are suffering from this acute tuberculosis. That is why the use of BCG vaccine is inhibited. If we talk about India, in India, Serum Institute will be manufacturing the vaccine being developed by Oxford University. But no Indian company seems to be the first curve of vaccine development. Blood thinners and blood thinning agents like aspirin also improves in the survival of patients infected from coronavirus in New York. In further studies, it is concluded that hydroxychloroquine is not effective against infection caused by COVID-19. In current studies, convalescent plasma was used to treat severely ill COVID-19 patients in China, found the therapy raised antibody titers, reduced viral load, and led to symptom improvement within 3 days. It also involves taking antibodies from the cured COVID-19 patients and injecting them in the blood of sick patients suffering from coronavirus. Over 90,000 healthcare workers worldwide may have been infected with COVID-19. According to an estimate from the International Council of Nurses, which represent 130 national associations and more than 20 million registered nurses. So here we conclude our introductory video on this coronavirus. We hope you all are safe in your houses. Please do use disinfectants, sanitizers frequently. Wear a mask whenever you go out of the houses. Thank you.
Thank you so much.